Hey, yo, band play.
Check, 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 check. One, two.
Episode 80.
I don't mean no harm, but I've been showing my ass lately. Large amounts daily. I've been going crazy. I've been dancing with the devil. God, can you save me? Every dope boy dream of riding a brand new Mercedes.
Let's go.
Say I'm her favorite. Dripping in the
you already know who it is. The dynamic duo in this bitch, man. Gatman and Robin, aka your boy, St. Icky, Kurt the King. We up in here, man. It's episode 80.
80 piece, man.
You already know.
And we got some special guests in the building.
Now, you say what's up to the people, man.
What's going on?
Now, say what up to the people.
What's going on? You
already know, man. We locked in.
We got two tag teams in here today. So we about to talk about a lot of things, really tap into what's going on with y'all, the culture in general.
Hell yeah, man. These two up-and-coming artists out of Chicago, man. What's that city y'all from? Where y'all from?
South side.
Yes, sir. Where at?
I'm everywhere.
Yeah, but you ain't never there.
Exactly.
I'm everywhere.
Yeah.
Man, I'm glad y'all made this trip, man. Cause this weather out here gnarly right now. So I appreciate y'all coming through, chopping it up with us.
Oh yeah,
appreciate
for sure, you having us. We appreciate the check.
Well, shit. I had originally got up on their music. Because Chuck Trizzy put me on y'all.
Right.
Chuck Trash put me on y'all.
Right.
And I think y'all had reached out to Chuck, right?
Originally, I remember Cam put True. Me on the Bad Luck, and then I sent him Low Key, and then from Low Key is my first post from y'all, and uh-huh. then from now I don't know if Chuck was the one who wrote the post. I honestly don't remember.
Yeah, that was Chuck.
But if it was written well, he probably wrote the post.
To be honest, I don't remember. Yeah. That was 2019. All I know is, but ever since, you know, shit, y'all was showing love. So I was like, it's hard for me not to, like, fuck with y'all. I was like, so, you know, y'all was fucking with us, so.
Yeah, man. So was, yeah, he played me y'all music, and I'm like, oh, yeah, this shit hidden for real.
Yeah, hey, I appreciate it.
Y'all was,
it.
Like, when we started to blog, y'all was, like, one of the first artists that, like, actually hit us up, and I actually really fucked with y'all music for real.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
And I kind of, not to get right into it, I do want to ask, in such a saturated music world, when y'all approach a project, how do you try to make it unique?
I don't know what to say. It's like, I can't try to make it unique. It's just like, I can just say I'm a real unique being type shit. I don't know what to tell you. Like, I guess from my influences and stuff like that, you know, I take, like, me and him, we'll be talking about artists and shit that's already on. And we'll be like, damn, man, imagine if they signed us or some shit. We'll executive produce their album type shit like that. Because we just feel like we know how to put good songs together and know how to put a solid project together. Even though I always just drop EPs and shit, but still, like, I know how to put tracks together, type shit like that. And, you know, what's the word I'm thinking about? Can't think of it, but yeah.
But shit, we was talking
like in a cohesive manner, just kind of try to make a blend.
We was talking about it right before, like, you just put out, like, little EPs and shit right now. And I feel you, because that's how I be feeling that, like, I don't want to put nothing out and people are not really going to listen to it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, like, attention span is so fast right now that niggas really only going to listen to the first two or three tracks. Exactly. They going to listen to the whole first one and a little bit of the second one, a little bit of the third one.
That's why I be making my songs short and shit. I be like, man, you know, whenever the label meetings happen, if they ask me, like, damn, what you going to do? I'm going to be like, shit, give me the money and I'm gonna make the songs longer. So simple as that.
But I think they even want the songs to be shorter though. That's the whole dynamic of the stream. Because if a song is like 2 minutes, you can stream it more. You just run it back.
That's the point. Like I want motherfuckers to tap in. Like that's crack. Like, you know, you like, damn, that shit was hard. And he ain't got nothing else. Let me hear that again. Let me hear it again. Let me hear it again. So it's like, in the words of Jay-Z, you got to baby feed them first. So it's like, you know, that's what we doing.
And that really let people actually connect to your music too. I remember, like, it's niggas that's out that's huge now, but I remember when they first came out, they only had a couple tracks that I listened to hella. We've been talking about since Cardi album dropped, and, like, I've been listening to Cardi forever, but I remember that's the effect that he had on me for real.
No, I was finna say, oh, I know you smoking.
Oh, yeah. No, I got mine. No. Hey, roll your own shit, smoke your own shit, man.
Okay, I got you. Facts. I feel you, it's 21, you know, so, you know, we got to say germ free type shit. But no, I was going to say, y'all, hell yeah, I'm a huge Cardi fan. I ain't even going to lie. Yeah. Like, man, first song I ever heard from bro was like Fetty.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Back first in them song, days,
for 2015,
real. Back in them days, for real. He ain't had no project.
Yo, and you want to know the funny thing is? I remember we went to the Cardi show before he dropped Magnolia type shit. Mm-hmm. So the show.
And what was that, at Double Door?
Yes, Double Door.
I was
doors,
up there.
Man, that show was so sick.
To have a show at
that
Double
show
door.
Was jumping. Yeah, we were supposed to have it. We were supposed to have a show up there like the month of close.
Month of close, yeah.
But what happened? Oh, yeah. So that, you know, the Double Doors Cardi show, when I remember we seen Andrew Barber type shit like that. So we hollered at him, was like, yo, you know, we ain't gonna fuck with us type shit like that. And he actually had the nerve to tell us, like, how many projects y'all got out?
Yeah, that's what he
and
had.
I'm like, bro, do you know who the hairline is? I bet that nigga ain't got
nothing at all.
Yeah, bro, like, funny. We had, but like, we legit, I think around that time, we probably just dropped our first tape.
Thing, yeah.
But before that, we was dropping songs.
Mm-hmm.
We was dropping songs a lot, so yeah.
Because that's how it is now, for real. Like, you gotta, it don't make sense to put out no whole body of work until you got people's attention.
Right. And then now me, I'm the exact opposite. I'm dropping whole bodies of work because it's like, no matter what, at the end of the day, people are going to listen to what they want to listen to.
Yep.
So it's like, people are going to come back to what they want to come back to. And well, I just want to get that, like, I can do a whole body of work. I can do a whole album. If you don't listen to the whole album, it's whatever. But when you come back, you're going to hear heat.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's like that whole other aspect of it. Then when someone does tap into your music, and if they fuck with it, you have a back catalog. Where some artists, if you're only putting out one song a week or something, and someone does fuck with one of the joints, you only got three back songs. But if you got a whole back catalog, they can become like tapped into your music.
Because at some point, I mean, I can't speak for nothing, but I know for me, I'm not going to be as consistent dropping music.
See, yeah, y'all said when we started recording, I told you. Bro, it's going to cap.
Man, young Quincy, wildin'.
He's a face value puppy. Yeah, but we were talking about like songs being short, and I kind of wanted to talk to you about this song on the Xmas joint, the Christmas joint. It was called Eyes.
The first
yeah. Song. So I have a couple questions about it. Was that inspired by a human in your life, or were you just in like a songwriter kind of state?
I mean, shit, he hit me. I'm gonna be honest. Like, well, I can break down how like the first two tapes went. The first tape was like mainly more he had more control of, and the second one I had more control of. So I mean, all I know is he had a verse and shit ready for me. So
I was thinking of, you know, there was, I'm not going to name any names, but there's, you know, there's some stuff going on with people we were hanging around, and they kind of just like, you know, just kind of changed dramatically out of nowhere. And so it's just like, that's what, to look me in your eyes, you know. Just,
yeah, that joint is fire, though. Yeah, I really liked it because you can tell there was like a deeper message behind it. Yeah. So I really, like, I backed that shit. Yeah. And that's why I was wondering if it was like y'all were really just in a songwriter mode, or
it
was based off shit. Some people are great at that. Just stepping outside of their own mind and writing songs. But some people can only write songs based on personal experience. So I was just kind of trying to see where you were at with that.
I thought I was that type of artist, but when it came to personal experiences, depending on how heavy the shit is, I can't write about it.
But why, though? Tap into that. Like, why? You think it's just too much?
Not at that moment. I got to come back to it. Oh, shoot.
So you kind of got to let it breathe for a minute?
Yeah.
And then write a song about it?
Come, let it breathe. I'm a more in the moment type of artist. When I hear something, if I really feel it, depending on what's going on, I'm not going to rewrite it. If that's what it is, it's it. If I don't like it, I'm throwing it out. It's done.
Mm-hmm. No, yeah, I feel you about like the album shit, man. That's, I really want to be an album artist for real.
Man, he inspired me every time.
Like, I cannot do it. I'll get to an EP length. The next thing you know, I'm like, I'm adding more songs. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I'm adding more songs.
Yeah. And in his case, it'll mainly be the producer. Like, they'll just be like, they'd be feeding you. It'll be like, all right, I can't listen to this now. I'm trying to focus on like finishing this EP type shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Enough About Me joint, Al Bundy, that wasn't even supposed to go on there. Like, my homie DJ Universe, shout out DJ Universe, he technically is supposed to produce that whole project. It's only four songs at first. That Al Bundy was getting so much love, like, I was just going to have it as a SoundCloud-only joint. But, you know, it was going so much love, and I was like, fuck it. Like, ever since I put it on there, a lot of people fuck with it even more, so I had to.
Yeah, definitely. And we were talking about this a little bit pre-pod. With the state of, like, the world, and especially Chicago as, like, a networking city, how's it been trying to make music when you can't really be around the scene and push the music to the two people?
Well, Chicago's already just too clicky in general.
In general.
So when it comes to, like, depending on what you... In all honesty, we don't even do most... Most of our networking is in other countries. Like, a lot of people... Like, just recently, a song that's on Quarantine Volume 2, Jupiter Heist... The lady, she's from France. I'm supposed to be doing a live performance with her on a pod, on like a Instagram from out there, basically. Mm-hmm. And there's something else that's going on and other stuff. But when it comes to that, I just, it's tricky. I can't explain how I don't really do it in here. I don't do it here. I don't really try to network in Chicago. I feel like there just is really kind of.
You can't.
It's like, eh.
You do who
do
you?
It's like you get there and you're like, who do you know? And I'm like, well, I don't know anybody. That's why I'm trying to get to where I'm trying to get to here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I feel like the internet really changed all of that. Because back in the day, you needed that hometown, like they needed to show love. But now with the internet, you have access to the whole world. Like yeah, you just yo. Said, like y'all are popping in other countries.
I say, look at Billie Eilish. I don't even know the fuck she's.
It's like, and what's
in the world? Fuck with her, heavy. Even though she like a you know industry client type shit.
Yeah. You know, and what blogs really popping in Chicago that got that's like right now?
BadLuck.
That too.
Yeah.
Hey. That too. That's all. But you know, you guys do what the people. This platform right here needs to be bigger because there's not that many platforms like yeah. that.
That was the whole reason that we had to start some shit.
Platforms like that. There's when it comes to like people I've tried to hit up. You guys were one of the only people that kind of like gave me feedback when I do drop stuff. And I was like, okay, because I'm not gonna lie. If when it comes to you know like people trying to like network and stuff, I'm gonna be biased to be like, yo, when I was trying to come up and do X, Y, and Z, you said no, so you're not gonna be able to post none of my music when that happens. Yeah. But that's gonna happen. Yeah.
It makes you feel like that. That's really
it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen.
It's like two dope boys with our future.
You guys are all good. You guys are good.
Ever.
Yeah.
After Frank or but Tyler.
Two Dope Boys was like the staple. Like if they didn't post your shit, you were kind of dead in the water, man. Like back in the day, like Two Dope Boys was that blog.
And you see the game has surpassed past them. Like it's not even now blogs are damn near dead. I was just talking to that dude yesterday and he was just like, man, blogs low key ain't even the way to go. But if you did want to do it, he just like was referring ways for me to like get in contact with him and shit like that.
Well, yeah, it's because like blogs were so relevant back in the day, but now you have so many different media streams feeding you information.
Yeah, I was gonna say it comes straight to you.
You don't need to go search out. Like, that's what you did. I mean, back in the day, like, dorking out on music, I had, like, 5-10 blogs I would visit every day. But you don't need to do that anymore. Because the shit is just fed directly to you, even if you're not asking for the information.
There was somebody, it was T.I. actually on a random old, like, I think a podcast, one of his, he mentioned it was, like, the 60,000 songs that get released in hip-hop, in the genre, a day. So it's like, when people ask, what do? You really can't do anything different. You can just release the music and I'm not even going to say hope, just continue to do what you're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the key element is just making sure you're putting like exactly what you want into the music. Because then if it goes across well, that's great. Because that's all you can do is put everything you really want to into it. Because like you said, there's 60,000 getting released. Nobody's checking for all that shit. You can't.
Yeah. I'm surprised he even knew that number. I thought it was like, I'm like, I didn't even do the research on it.
This man
reads
dictionaries when he's bored. Of course he's doing shit like that.
Yeah.
So wait, bag everything up. How y'all know each other?
High school.
High school, where y'all go to school at?
South Suburbs, where I'm like raised at, type shit like that.
Okay.
Born in like. No, clearly Chicago.
What high school you go to?
Thornwood.
Oh, Thornwood, true. I went to HF.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Hell yeah.
Crazy. The hoes is at HF. I'm going to keep it a buck.
Somebody went to the Wood, but I'm not claiming the high school. I went to Robeson. I'm not claiming the high Robeson.
Hell yeah. So y'all always been, how long y'all been making music together? What's the first time y'all made a song?
Bro, like,
tell me about
music
that.
Music is the reason how we became cool. Like,
okay, to be honest,
it was his brother. It's his brother. I knew his brother since like first grade type shit, and I started hanging with his brother just to find a new vibe in like my freshman year type shit like that. And shit, I remember me and his brother was probably writing some bullshit ass song, and this nigga was in the other room, I think, playing a game because you know I really wasn't like friends with him. I was friends with his brother. So next thing you know, we rapping and shit like that. He like, man, y'all niggas can't rap.
Cause I'm like, yeah, it was like, it's my little brother. And I swear, I'm like, bro, you weren't doing none of this music shit until you heard me doing it. So I was like, when did this happen?
So it's been day one for me type shit. And then like we, from high school, we was doing like Facebook, we was doing like freestyles. Like we'll post like 3 freestyles a day type shit like that. And like summer of 2010, 2011 type shit like that. And yeah, you know, we was just getting like Facebook love and shit like that. But besides that, it was cool. And then from there, you know, we kind of progressed with it. You know, now I want to say 2014 was a hot year for us somewhat. And then, you know, we kind of took a step back 2015. And I feel like at the 2017 plus is like where we making our stamp. Like, you know, shit where you can find our shit that, like, you know, you can recognize it.
What is both of y'all like inspiration? Where does like the music come from? Like, what were y'all listening to when you decided to tap in and make music?
Damn, like who inspired me to make
music? Yeah, you know. Because I mean, I feel like your style is kind of unique, but in a hip hop way. You know, like you and some like rap shit. It's like hip hop.
I'm gonna say like early shit. Like I'm gonna say like Shad Moss. I'm gonna say fucking.
But that is the wildest inspiration I've ever heard.
I'm gonna say Shad Moss.
He inspired niggas. Exactly, he made like young niggas.
Because you was like, a kid exactly, and you was like folks doing this. I can do this.
Yeah.
He had. Kanye West for sure.
Yeah.
For sure.
Of course.
Changed my life since College Dropout. I bought every album.
Hell yeah. I remember before College Dropout came out, like them songs that's on Freshman Adjustments. I remember I had them bitches on a CD, just a random CD I had. Uh-huh.
So now that like we've got to live with these Ye albums for so long, what's your actual favorite Kanye project?
For me, it's always
Both of y'all.
I'm interested. I mean, well, I don't even go back on the question you asked for the start of me started rapping. My granny actually put me on to Kanye West, and she was one of the reasons why I actually started rapping, because she was a poet. She played the saxophone. So sixth grade, I started playing the sax. After that, rest in peace, she passed probably in seventh grade. So I just was like, I'm done with that shit. Next thing you know, I was really done with anything after like art in general.
Morning.
And then I was like, you know what? I need something to do. And I bought So those one, Demon Days by Gorillaz.
Oh, true.
and then that's when I got into MF Doom, because in November has come on track 9. I was like, oh, shit, this is so Doom and just all that. But my granny, she put me on Ye, and I would say Late Registration, because that was the album she...
My favorite project.
She was really bumping in the whip, surprisingly. I was like, what the fuck is this?
Late Registration, to me, like, I feel like I'm a Kanye-ologist. That's what I call myself, like, because I'd be studying his, like, his music and shit. I'm like, if you ask me, like, his best album is Late Registration, hands down.
Yeah.
But my favorite album is always just going to be College Dropout, because, like, that changed my life. Type shit like that. Even though I was so young, but, like, it changed my mind state. Like, I was like, yo, like,
I think so he brought a different sound into, like, mainstream rap. You know, he brought, like, that into, like, the super light, because he was on, like, Rockefeller and shit, you know, so.
Yeah, yo.
But now that all these albums have aged.
When they dropped, they had them chains, when them chains first came out, that was one of the hardest rap chains I ever seen in my life.
I still get a rock chain.
So when you started to tap into Doom, like, how did you feel about it? When you, like, heard Doom and then you started to tap into his discography?
I mean, instantly, for one, I mean, I really wasn't listening to rap, but it was ironic. The first album I bought ever was a rap album, just off the look of the cover, and it was Scarface, because my granny, she was like, she just got a little Windstar van. She was like, you can get a CD to play in now. I'm like, I bet. Next thing you know, I'm like, she was like, get something. I'm like, it was red. It was decent. It was greatest hits. I was like, get it. I was like, because I was PlayStation 2 games, greatest hits.
Two cups.
And, you know, and I'm like, whatever. But then, so it was Scarface. That was the first rap album I bought. But Doom after that was just, man, I was just surprised at how he was, what he was saying on the track. That's what I was just so surprised at. I was like, dang, this man is really just like a poet speaking, and then just how, what he's really just mumbling, saying a bunch of things, and it was just crazy.
Yeah. He really just like so smoothly bar shit down.
Yeah.
You know, like he's just saying, like, you really got to dissect every verse, because he's saying so much in every verse, you know.
I recently, I was just telling him, because clearly, you know, he just passed away or whatnot, and I was saying, like, I found out so much little shit that I didn't know about. Like, I didn't know Mad Villainy had originally leaked. Like, Mad Lib lost the cassette like that.
Yeah.
And then next thing you know, they just redid it type shit. And then also, I didn't know, like, after, like, it was technically done. Doom was like, let me just redo those verses again. They sound a little sloppy. Like, he legit just went in. Like,
they got Mad Villainy too. That's never came out.
Yeah, I know. Can't wait. They already gave it the thumbs up, I heard.
Yeah, for sure.
Hopefully it comes soon.
Yeah, man.
I mean, Doom was like, you know, he was on the KMD shit. Like, he was, and then his brother passing, I feel like, just put him on a weird trajectory.
Yeah.
Where, like, you could see that's when he kind of, like, tapped into, like, the sadness type shit. Where he's a very, like, to me, a tragic kind of human. you know, a lot of his bars, if you really listen, it comes from like sadness. Of course. But he's just like literally barring shit down.
That's like, why he's like a super villain, because that's another thing I found. Mm-hmm. Like Doomsday was inspired off his brother.
Exactly.
Like, it was like fucking Jason killing for his mom type shit like that. But he like, I'm finna do this rap shit for my brother type shit like that. And I'm not going to play games with it.
So. And he didn't. And I mean, he put out like hard ass shit all the time. You know, sometimes you need that like passion to drive you. You know, something just needs to kick in and just put you in that mode where you're like, fuck it, I'm just doing this shit. Like, I'm giving it everything. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah. Hell yeah. I really appreciate the frequency y'all drop, for real. Y'all drop hella.
Damn, yeah. You could blame the mixtapes back in the day, man. I was seeing Currency do that shit. I'm like, man, he doing this shit. Why can't I?
Yeah,
but you know, doing it like, why can't I?
Andretti. Good Fridays,
they dropping, I'm dropping.
Hell yeah, yeah.
You don't ever feel like it oversaturates it?
We kind of really just got. I do.
I feel like that. I feel like that. That's like the L's. That's like the L's of the game. You be like, man, maybe I'm going a little too crazy. But then at the end of the day, when you get those random ass comments, like just from people to be like, yo. I really appreciate that you're doing whatever you're doing on your page or, you know, your Twitter or whatever. So it's just, it really doesn't
matter. Hell yeah.
It's just whatever.
One thing about Spitta drop all the time, but like, you can't, I ask people, I was like, tell me a lounge Spitta song. Can you tell me a bad Spitta song? Can we put it on and we judge it?
I'm not going to say bad. I'm not going to say bad. But I'm going to say one that I'm like, this is not my favorite.
This is not my favorite. Exactly. This is not my favorite one, but you can't find nothing bad from Spitta, for real.
Like, damn.
The thing about a Currency record is you can play any of them and it's just going to be smooth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
The way he buying it down.
But also it does get you to the point where like you wouldn't really have, to me, I'm still like, oh, Pilot Talk is tight. Cause that's when he was still.
This is best shit today. I don't care what nobody says.
Yeah. Pilot Talk 1 is fucking crazy. All like, three. But then it just gets to a point where now it's like, I can put on any Currency record, but I don't have like a favorite go-to unless it's Pilot Talk or something like Pilot Talk 1, 2,
so wait, 3. Hold on. So that's your favorite. What's your favorite Currency?
Pilot Talk 1.
That's not my favorite Currency.
What's your favorite Currency?
Pilot Talk 1.
I'll say exactly.
Let's just say, what's your favorite Currency album?
Album Project. Album
Project.
Oh, Covert Coup.
Exactly.
Alchemist. Alchemist.
I got that on vinyl at the crib right now.
Dude, that had Scottie Pippen's on it, did it?
Okay, so Alchemist is a fucking cheat code, though. Alchemist is a cheat code. Because the shit he does is just perfect. He's so fucking amazing at tapping in with these artists and really putting them in their place. Like, where he's giving them the beats where they're going to, like, shine on.
Alchemist actually hasn't never really. I don't think he's missed with a project.
He doesn't miss. He straight doesn't miss.
I don't think he ever has.
Nah, at all.
I haven't heard a project with an artist that was like, eh. There might have been some things on there but every beat was hard.
Yeah. the thing is, Alchemist's legacy is nuts because he was making fucking Mobb Deep beats and shit. You know what I mean? And now he's doing Elfredo with Gibbs and it's amazing. It's a Grammy nominated fucking album.
Also on the Jay Electronica Jay Z shit nominated. So it's like, that's crazy. He's everywhere now.
I was on Jay Electronica back in the day from Two Dope Boys and I was waiting for him to drop for so long. And I like the new record. Too. But I think Jay should have dropped back in the day. Like, he was so on fire with all that shit. When he was rapping over, like, Eternal Sunshine and shit. Like,
I'm not going to lie.
With the raps, it's just, like, it get somewhat hard. And I ain't going to lie. So, I'm like, I can only imagine who Jay was. You can look how you want to look. Bro, I must have listened to Better In Tune the other day with Infinite. I'm over here like, man, this is shit. I need it. And that song today is still better than any verse on that new album.
When Jay didn't drop the album back in the day, I knew it. Because I was listening to the man. I was like, yo, this man's on another level, like, already. And his album didn't drop. So I'm like, you're telling me he's about to drop an album? I'm like, there's no way that's going to happen. I said it. I was like, there's no way that's going to happen.
You know, the thing about Jay Electronica was that he would tap into some, like, spirituality shit, but not sound corny. Like, he would just give you these bars that were, like, a little bit deeper than rap shit, but it sounded so, like, authentic.
Yeah, it was low-key.
And you didn't take it, like, corny.
I remember somebody made a point saying, like, if Drake was saying that shit, then you would have found a coin.
Exactly. But Drake isn't Jay. Like, you can tell Jay Electronica's really tapped into, like, his spirituality and shit. And, I mean, Drake is, like, he'll get you deep on, like, Take Care and shit. And it hits the way, like, we had this conversation the other night. Like, Drake can take you to, like, the I'm a rapper, I got money shit. Or he can take you to the emotion shit. But Jay Electronica, it's more like spirituality. Like, he'll take you to, like, a really mental place. Like, deep in your thoughts.
I was going to say the corny shit with Drake is, like, mix the what you just said together, like the emotions and the money.
I can't even call Drake corny. I feel like we let a lot of corny stuff slide already in hip hop. So it's like, what's corny? Yeah. Like, what's corny?
What, I mean, expound on that though. What do you mean?
I mean,
He ain't gonna name drop.
I can't because I'm not. I mean, I'm not gonna personally say anybody's name. But I'm like, I've heard some artists that like people done played, and I'm like,
man, Post Malone.
You think this is cool?
I mean,
but you'll hit on Drake because he said what? Like, but you're listening to this.
Yeah. I feel like Post is like a melodic master though.
I fuck with
the
Post.
Only reason.
No, I was just talking shit. I was just saying. But I mean, he is.
There's some artists that you can't.
You
take
know, you
seriously.
Fuck with older Post shit. Then you fuck with new Post shit.
Yeah. All new Post shit sounds the exact same. Like he literally comes
on. Stony sound like that last album.
No, I'm talking about the new Post Malone shit. Literally sounds like the same song over and over again. He's like flowing in the same cadence and shit. It's like
some people could say a Currency song. Some people could say like a Mac DeMarco. All songs sound the same, but it's just like if you tapped in. And it's just like, you understand the art.
What's tapped in?
Yeah. I fuck with the Mac DeMarco reference.
Let's get that deeper. What's tapped in? What's
tapped in? All that shit. All right,
so yo.
You got the Stones and shit out. What you talking about tapped in?
Now, your favorite Spitta album?
Covert Cool. I just said I have it on mine.
You said album. That's the mixtape.
Yeah, I'm thinking of like Project.
I'm going to go on that. I feel like Pilot Talk 2 is his best Pilot Talk.
He think Pilot
Talk. Pilot Talk 1 is better than 2.
Nah.
King Kong and shit.
They both style.
King Kong and Pilot Talk 2. I'm sorry.
I like 2.
The first song on Pilot Talk 2, Airborne Aquarium. Just
oh, that beat comes in so crazy.
Every other team said that's his favorite beat that he made.
I like Weekend at Bernie's.
That's a good one. No. Look, yeah, because you got She Don't Want a Man.
Yeah, she a little fuck. Yeah,
you got Pound Sign Jess.
Weekend at Bernie's was like the first mixtape I heard chicks actually asking me about. Like when I said like you like Spitta, they was like, yeah, I heard Weekend at Bernie's. I was like, wow. Like this the album? Right? Like I guess I don't know.
I think it's a cover. That's a cover.
Currency said that shit perfect. He's like, dude. The girls that like my albums are the strippers that go home and count the money to my shit. He's like, they're listening to turned up shit all day when they're like working, and they come home and count their money to my music. And that is what you do. You put on some Currency. Like
Burning Sage and shit like that, coming home after they strip and shake their ass to talk the music and be like, those
they get playing the game and shit. Playing the game and shit. You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy. It's funny to think like that though. But some bitches paying for college, so I ain't surprised at this point.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with any of it. I mean,
not at all.
That shit is great. I mean, it's like people, it's obviously a huge like industry. So.
Shout out the dancers, man.
But there's only, I mean, Currency doesn't make like strip club music, but he makes it for when they're done working and they're like chilling. Like, you know what I mean?
Like you could play, you could almost play anything at a strip club, really, almost, no bad.
You can or you can't?
You can.
You can.
You can.
That's why you got a responsibility as a DJ, because you can really play anything. That's why you have a responsibility as a DJ to know what's hot, because you could really just put out anything.
Yeah,
because
it's all on the strippers.
That's how niggas was making it back in the day.
They can do whatever they want to
shit like
that. It's really nothing. What else are they going to do different?
But I think, yeah, they got to be in tune with what's going on. You know what I mean? You can't, I don't know. I feel like there's certain music that might not fit the element. You got to get the mood right. That's the same thing if you're at the crib and we're playing some music even before the pod. I feel like we're playing Benny and we set the kind of mood for the pod.
Mm-hmm.
The music can change the whole mood of a room, you know? So
I'm going to say anything, but not almost anything. But I feel like I could definitely DJ a strip club and not play some trap shit and it'll be lit still. Like without a doubt.
I feel like you could get into like a weird R&B bag and it'd be like kind of
sexy. It gotta be like mad smooth. I need like Vice City.
Just throw the party on something, you know.
Because party still got the drums.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Or like some
slow Future.
Yeah. Right. All the Hendrix. Like just a whole Hendrix straight party for real.
Hendrix was fire. That's what I remember he was getting at my man Scotty Pippen.
That was Future.
Because he said he didn't sign an autograph.
That shit, Larson doing decks. What you think? I was just like, we gotta keep
that shit was so. That shit.
Larson out here.
I kind of want to like switch gears for a second, but we'll definitely bounce back to the music. On one of your album covers, you're wearing a Pleasure shirt, and then you got the song Rare Bape. What's the connection to like streetwear fashion type shit? Like y'all dork out on the culture? Or like,
yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I love the fashion. I'm not a hype beast though. I guess I'm a.
Why are you mad about that though? Are you sure you're not a hype beast?
What am I wearing?
There's nothing wrong.
You want to know how I'm not a hype beast? I don't wear Nike. That's
what doesn't mean you're not what?
I'm not a hype beast. I don't wear Nike. But I'm gonna tell you right now. But like,
it doesn't make sense.
I'm just not a hype. Yes, it does. It makes plenty of sense.
I'm gonna say it.
It makes plenty of sense.
Make it make sense.
I feel like we're about to have a conversation.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, talk about it.
Only Nike I wear is like Converse. Is Nike is
Nike isn't like, associated with being a hype beast. That's like wild ass association.
It's like Jordans and shit like that. Yes, it is. That's because you think like
it's
that.
Deeper
you
than like, that. It's
deep. Exactly. What's deeper than it? What's deeper than it?
What do you mean? Just I think if you wear some Jordan 11s, you're not a hype beast, bro. Maybe you like the 11s.
But I'm just saying. Exactly. That's my point. So it's like, so how do we separate the hype beast and hipster and yo?
I mean, why does that name like matter? I mean, if you like cool shit, you might be a hype beast. Why? Like,
I'm gonna tell you, I'm a hype beast for music, but I'm not a hype beast for clothes.
Same.
I just feel like there's so much falsitivity to this shit. What do you mean? If you wear fly shit, you're probably associated as being a hype beast. Why are you so mad about the title, though?
Just accept it. Yeah,
I'm not.
No. Who has hurt you? Who hurt you? Is that what the song is about?
See, I'm smoking. I ain't gonna lie. Red Bay, I just cold.
Yeah, who hurt you, bro? Nah, some girl told you were hypebeast. You took that shit mad personal.
Nah, hell nah. A bitch never told me I was a
back in the day, though, that is like something you didn't want to be, though. Like a hypebeast.
Yeah, but I feel like it has a...
But I feel like I'm like...
It has an unnecessary negative connotation.
I still call like the little Yeezy stores that be in like the mall. I call them the hypebeast stores. Like,
but you be in those stores.
You ask me why I'm wearing some shit.
I ain't gonna lie. If you want to call me a hypebeast for the Yeezys, ball out. You know why? Because I'm trying to get that Adidas deal. You know, hopefully they tapped in the face.
Ask me why I'm wearing some shit. I'm gonna be straight up shooting. And I hope it's hot.
I'm trying to get an Asics deal too. You know.
I definitely want you to know I'm not like trying to come at you negatively. I don't think there's negative connotation towards that like word. It means you know about cool shit. Yeah, I mean whatever. Like
it's a magazine called it. You can't cap and say it's not hypebeast. Like man, this dude a hypebeast. Like you could just look at look at somebody's outfit sometimes and just be he really put all that together and you just looking at him like get out of here.
That's deeper than that's deep.
Get out of here.
But it's a matter of taste though for
that's
real.
The point. That's
curating. You gotta curate your fit.
It's the taste.
You know,
that's the word I was looking for. I know how to curate projects.
But just out of straight curiosity, how did you start fucking with a brand like Pleasures? Because it's kind of like a niche little thing.
I just came out like, I ain't gonna let's hype now, but like, I gotta go on my hypebeast.
I know.
Don't worry about him. He a hypebeast.
Hey, call me what you want.
Bro. Anyway, how do you get on Pleasures?
My shit ain't whack. Pleasures cool. You wanna know the funny thing is, I had the convo with my homie when we made the cover, and he wanted to Photoshop it out. And I was like, nah, you know, leave it in there. Like, why not? It's not like I'm finna. I mean, it could be hot. It could be like hot, like the hottest shit right now. But at the same time, it's just like, nah, leave that shit in there. You know, I fuck with Pleasures, and I want them to see that. So it's like, that's how I was feeling about it. And Pleasures, they dope. Like, they tapped into like the underground punk shit like that, and the old punk shit from like a Sonic Youth. So like, I mean, you know, you got the Nirvana too. That's not, you know, so out there. And
They be doing all them collabs. The Korn, they did Korn.
They did the Marilyn Manson shit. I got a bunch of Marilyn Manson shit. I got like three of those things. Yeah.
The Korn was hard.
You working at St. Alfred? I know they got it up there.
Yeah, those are the homies. They carry Pleasures for sure. Like Joe Shea, shout out Joe. We'll probably get him on the pod at some point. He used to design all the St. Alfred shit.
St. Alfred, yeah.
Yeah. So
I think I know who you're talking about. Since we excluded this hypebeast shit, so what's your favorite brands right now?
ALD, like Ami Leon Dior is like.
I know, I just seen a picture over there. Yeah, amazing. I was like, that's dope. Yeah, like, that's sick.
I got a bunch of that shit. I rock a lot of fuck with Kith. I think they do like I'm like grown at this point, you know, so I've been trying to like wear like minimally branded type shit. That's why these St. Alfred hoodies are great, because it's just got the little A. You know, I've been like definitely toning it down on like the logos and things, and Kith fits into it, ALD fits into it.
Tell me about
just kind of like growing up, but still fucking with streetwear, you know, because I grew up skateboarding, fucking love clothes, obviously, but like sometimes, you know, like Cream or Palace or something, it's like heavily branded, you know, so I've kind of been moving away from that shit a little bit. And Pada, I like love Pada. Pada's like my favorite shit.
Pada, I remember that, like Pigel and Palace.
Yeah, like I mean, Palace is amazing, like, but like I said, it's a little heavy branded.
Like back in the day, like a couple years ago, that's when they was like making better quality shit, I'll say.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Palace, like, I love where they're still at though, because they kind of blew up, but I think they're killing it harder than Supreme with design wise. Like,
recently?
Yeah, for sure.
I think that too.
Supreme fell all the way the fuck off, honestly.
Last Palace drop was better than Supreme last drop, is what you're telling me.
I mean, what drop are we talking about?
Like,
I mean, the last Supreme the drop was like one. The last Supreme drop was like really bad.
There you said it was, but you saying Palace is better than that though. I'm not gonna say it was that. I mean, look, they had the Stone Island collab that was sick.
Yeah,
they had the Yoji Yamaha.
Well, the Stone Island shit is weird though too because they recently got sold, so I feel like Stone Island's gonna go like, in a different direction. Where I mean, maybe not like stylistically, but
hold on, who got bought by
Supreme? Got bought by Vans.
Who got Michael Kors? Michael Kors by Versace. That's on Versace. That's what West Ham made that song.
Yeah, yeah.
Even though Versace was never really that high after Gianni died.
Exactly. Honestly, I feel like still, that, like the Medusa will always be timeless. But honestly, if I got bread like that and I'm shopping, I'm probably not going to
pull up on Versace. I'll be a hypebeast and get the robe. Yeah,
the robe is crazy, though. That's just a move. I'll get the robe. Yeah. Man. But I'm not going to wear a Versace shirt. Like, I'm kind of gay.
That's
like,
the draws, maybe. But you know what I'm
saying? Yeah. I wear polo, man.
That's how you know. That's how you know your throwback.
No.
Man, Ralph, I wear polo.
Man, I say the trappers wear Ralph. Back in the day,
trappers, you know what I'm saying?
Man, you don't know how polo, many motherfuckers was in high school selling Ralph and shit. Niggas be like stealing the fuck out of that shit. Amazing shit.
I mean, Ralph Lauren had the moment of moments. I mean, that shit was like the low life shit. Like that was so immersed in hip hop too. You know what I mean? Like polo was so immersed in like hip hop music.
What's that song? What's the 411 with Mary J and Grand Poobah. And they say a polo line. I forgot. Jabo's Hank is saggy. He said heel figure, not polo. And I'm still thinking about it though. But yeah, still though, that was still a sick line though. And I was just saying like, yeah, polo just a forever thing. It's just like Gucci or Louis type shit like that.
Yeah, but the thing with Gucci, forever, like I mean,
yeah, it's higher class, but I'm just saying like it's like a forever thing to me.
For sure, and I guess now that we're talking about it, to me,
plus
like...
don't wear a lot of polo, too. I'm going to throw that out. Yeah, like, don't wear a lot of polo, too.
Can't go wrong. Yeah, exactly. Can't go wrong.
with like, Gucci and Louis now, especially with, like, Virgil being at Louis and Alessandro doing what he's doing at Gucci, like, they're both just feel too, like, streetwear. It's like, bro, like, if you want to fuck with streetwear, why... You don't need to spend $3,200 on the shit, you know? Like, you should really fuck with streetwear. Like, Gucci is basically a streetwear brand now. Like, they just did a collab with North Face, and the shit was
Gucci
like...
Gucci is horrible now.
Yeah, that shit, I thought that shit
I fucked
cool.
with that coat.
Yeah. I'm coat if thing, I said yeah. it's not no products, I wouldn't wear it. Yeah. I'm just saying...
But I'm saying, I don't think Gucci needs to be a streetwear brand. Why are you presenting your apparel like
Virgil.
This?
That's what I'm going to say. They got to find their Virgil.
But Virgil's turning Louis into a streetwear brand. I mean,
like what Virgil do. It was... Virgil
well, how do you feel about the
Virgil Kim Jones,
the Lucian skate shoe? You know, I mean, that's kind of a weird look.
Which one?
Like they did a Louis skate shoe.
Yeah.
Somebody was wearing it, right?
Lucian Clark is like the dude that it's his shoe.
I'm trying to see how the fuck it look. I think it was sick, wasn't it?
It looks like an old DC shoe. Like
it was. All right, so how do you feel about when A$AP Rocky did that shoe?
He did the Osiris shoe. Yeah.
How do you feel about that? That you were fucking with it? I thought that was kind of like
I was never a skater back in the day, but I love skating type shit like that. You know, for real, all that. I was that
thing
that Tony Hawk low shit
real,
like that.
I actually grew up skateboarding.
Terry Kennedy,
I know
all them type shit like that. But I was gonna say exactly, and I didn't attempt it. You know, I was in my mind mentally, I was like, black people ain't supposed to be doing that shit like that. You know, I wasn't trained. You know, I wasn't programmed right at that time. So at the same time, it's just like. You know, it's like how I feel about it. He did it. I mean, he got the person who designed the original one, so I can't be mad about it.
Oh, with the ASAP shit. Yeah. No, he hollered at Dave Mayhew. That was the dude that did the D3 back in the day. But I just feel like, honestly, skateboarding has so much of an impact on fashion in general.
Oh, yes.
It's always had. Like
it's connected. You see from, like, kids' 90s movies and shit like
that. It's because it's a melting pot for everybody. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. Like, rap shit was born in New York, and skateboarding was... thriving in New York, and they like fed off each other. You know, the hip hop culture and the rap shit like fed off each other.
And it's because it's some other shit where you will see a motherfucker and you be like, oh, he go hard. You can't say that he don't go hard. It's something that you do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He could be a punk nigga. You could be a b boy. You know what I'm saying? Y'all both skate.
What Drake say? On So Far Gone, he said that line about the hipsters gonna get along with the hood niggas.
Yeah, these hipsters gonna get along.
Hipsters gonna get along with the hood niggas.
So hey, you know who I see really to bring it all the way back? Like this nigga Freddie Gibbs, he used to have that shit back in the day. I remember I used to go to Freddie Gibbs show and I was like, damn, it's literally the hipsters in the hood.
I believe that because look, we went to I say my first Freddie Gibbs. That's the first time seeing him.
That was my first time seeing them
when they had like Griselda and Cousin Steers and shit like that.
Oh yeah,
we were at
there.
That show.
We was up there.
It was so fucking bitch, bro.
Oh my god,
sense.
It was.
Oh yeah, we was decent. We was on stage.
Your boys was in the VIP. We was in the VIP.
Shout out Effie.
Yeah, because I remember getting in there because we got in there late because it was so fucking packed. It was packed. It was so packed. We got in there late as hell.
Yeah, Benny and them.
I was like, can we go upstairs?
Conway is the best performer all night, and it blew my mind.
All right, so now that we got y'all and y'all both really fuck with rap, who's the best rapper in Griselda?
Come on.
I'm Benny all day. I think Benny's by far the best rapper.
Playing Benny when we came in, so I'm not shocked. Yeah. Oh, I'm not sure. Hold on, let me ask you a question. We're gonna stick to this topic. How did you feel about his last project with Hit-Boy?
I would have rather had it not be fully produced by Hit-Boy, but there was some shit on there. Like there was some heat on there, but there's only like honestly, man, like five tracks. Like the Thank God I Made It shit. The intro was crazy. The shit with all three of them always goes crazy whenever they're all in the same shit.
Yeah. But me, I'm gonna just say when you say rapper, Benny, he's the good. He got the best bars out the group. You talking about rapping? When it comes to Benny, I get that same flow. Conway's the only one I heard. That's really Conway, just giving me something like at least a different flow, like on Calvin. That's giving me something quick.
Also, you got to give that to Al though, because Al made the beat. Like Al will put you in a different pocket.
How about that Ghost album though that Conway did though?
That's a good one too. That's a good one. Al made the beat, but Conway was rapping that like that. He could have did something different, but it was just
my thing with Conway is not Conway.
So you saying that if Benny need an Al project to really like?
No, I'm not saying that at all. I just really genuinely feel like Benny has the best. He's the best rapper out of those. Out of the crew. I think like Conway, like you said, he can give you some different cadences or something, but the shit Benny says is, I don't think any other really rappers are giving it to you like that. He'll paint the same picture in 30 ways, like literally, which is crazy. Because it's not like Benny's like subject matter is really vast. It's the same subject matter, but he's giving it to you in 30 fucking different ways.
Don't count out Westside either, man. You can't count out Westside though.
Yo, people be hating because on Westside so much.
Westside really paint a picture for real. He really be putting together moods for real.
Westside does what he does. I think he painted a picture better than me. I think he painted a picture better. Like, honestly, for me, like, Benny, Conway, like, they better rappers. Not gonna lie, like, they can probably give it to you more consistently. Westside, not the guy you go to for flow.
Westside, you gotta have a fashion reference.
Yeah, I feel like I'm watching.
And my thing is, he gonna give you the best fashion reference to both.
Look, man, I feel like when Westside drop a project, it's like when HBO dropped like a True Detective. You know what I'm saying? Like, I watched the whole thing go down from
Westside knows how to put out a whole project. He curates a project. Where Benny's just gonna rap his ass up.
He be saying hard shit that don't have like nothing to do with a verse either. Like you would like this should never be in a rap verse, but this what he did, but what he said for real.
Man, it's the cadence. I love West.
Well, he'd be like, get the bleach.
Yeah, how you say shit. And it's funny, people kill me. They be like, I don't like the sound of his voice. Yeah. And I'm like, don't listen to him then, because the nigga is cold.
I'm glad he's bringing that hard shit back. I'm happy about it.
That was the last show we went to before the COVID.
Me too.
Yeah. We rose up me in that bitch. Yeah. He came out in the Montclair. Yeah. Like the floor length Montclair.
Y'all was in the back of that one too?
No, we was in the front. Nah, he was in the back. We told him, like, what happened was I got in there. I'm like, this bitch thick than a motherfucker, right? Kelly was like, let's just go to the front. I was like, nah, I ain't going up there. That shit ugly.
Yeah, I'm trying to see.
And then, like, I don't know how, somehow she convinced me to go up there. And, like, it was like the bar was right by the seats and shit. But once you got past the bar, didn't nobody walk past the bar because it looked fucked up. But it was a big ass pocket right in front of the stage. I was walking around with my drink up and shit.
But I'm saying the best moment of that night is when Benny dropped 5-50. When that shit comes on, it's just game over.
Yeah, it was over with.
I'm not gonna lie, man. West was killing it for me. I don't know what you're talking about. That was my first time seeing West the whole night.
That was
my second time seeing Benny. So I was like,
Were you at the fucking shitty ass show at Bourbon on Division? Because that was nuts.
Oh, bro. They played it. It was just Benny. It was when Tana Talk came out.
Hell no, it was just Benny.
It was just Benny at Bourbon on the Vision, right? Wow. So me and Chuck went, and we get there or whatever, right? And then it was a line. And we were standing in line and we like, oh, they go Conway. Like, oh, Conway here. That's what's up. So we go up there Mind you, man, because we ain't had no tickets. Man, we went there early as fuck. Mind you, it was like 6 o'clock, bro. These niggas didn't come on till 1. Niggas was fed up and mad, booing and shit.
And they not even that big for them. It was,
they weren't that big then at all.
That's crazy.
Bro, like, it was literally like 42 openers, right? Niggas was throwing shit, booing niggas off stage and shit. Yeah. Shout out my nigga Fillmore Green. He played that shit. And he captured the crowd, but like, nice. It was a nigga that said something about D-Rose. He was like, shoot him in his knee like he D-Rose. Nigga said... Boo! Get this nigga off the stage. Everybody look around. Everybody just start booing this nigga. I'm like, bro, you can't stand up about D-Rose.
You can't
bro.
Do that. No,
you not can't do that. No. But then, Biddy came out. He brought Conway in. West came out. I'm like, deal. Man, yeah. Bourbon on the Vision.
I wish.
The crazy thing about that show was like, me and my boy Jorge pulled up, and we were like later than Perry was. And they were like, yeah, it's sold out. And it I was like, dead. Damn, whatever is dead. And Jorge's like, nah, G, fuck it. So we go through like the bottom floor of the bar and we go to these back stairs. And Jorge talks to the dude that's at the stairs. And he's like, stage upstairs? And dude's like, yeah. And he's like, bet. And we just go up this back stairs, walk through the stage, come down into the show for the free. Dude. Like, when they were like, it's sold out. This shit is dead. Wow. But there was literally like, that room was probably 200 people and there was like 400 people.
Bro, niggas was falling out. It was
nuts. Smoking cigarettes and shit. Yes, it was nuts.
Everybody was smoking. Every single person in there was smoking, bro. Yeah, I almost died in that show. Yeah, I got lightheaded. I had to go outside. I remember. I was like, I got to go outside,
man,
bro.
Man, that shit happened to me at the Freddy show. That shit pissed me off. That shit pissed me off. Freddy came out that the nigga was Pac. I ain't going to lie to you. He came out playing the crime pays and shit.
How you feel about Freddy's breath control? That shit is nuts.
When he get loud as fuck.
Yeah. No, his breath control is just crazy. Oh, yeah. He can rap for like
his shit loud.
7 minutes, dude. Like,
bro, that nigga Fred was playing. We was at the top watching this shit. And I'm just like, bro, he's so good at rapping. Like, he hit every word. And then, like, we was coming around the back. He was coming off. Like, when I
that was a different show. That was a different show.
Oh, but this show, whatever. I was like, when I see Fred, I'm finna tell him.
Oh, yeah, Fred's
I was so hyped. I was like, when I see him, I'm finna tell
he's
him.
He's one of the performers that I just like, you look at him, he's like, first off, because he does not, he's rapping with the beat. So mm-hmm. That's already
look, out, but that out show you talking mind. About, I was going to say, that's the one where I said Conway, I thought Conway performed better than Freddie that night, the night I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Because Freddie, like, it was just Conway, he just had me shocked. Like, I was like, I knew this dude could spit, but just like you said, like, his breath control on me, like, what's that joint?
Yeah, the cow, he goes crazy.
The cow was cool, but it's funny, it's the one that Jay-Z asked him about.
Mm, that so was the cow. When he talks about getting shot in the face and all this shit.
I'm going to tell you right now.
I think it's the cow, bro.
I know Alchemist produced it.
Al did? Yeah. I don't know, yeah, you got to look that up. But that show was crazy. Like, everything about that show was good vibes, you know? Even, like, except for that dude rapping over the double, Stiz. Was rapping over the double.
I fuck with Cousin Stiz, though.
But you can't rap over your
I fuck with Cousin Stiz. That's not good. He had never heard Stiz before then.
Stiz, nice. I ain't gonna lie with you.
Yeah.
But you can't rap over your doubles, dude.
He had never heard Cousin Stiz before that night, and he was sick.
I do it and I don't do it. I do it.
Why do you do it? Let's talk about it, actually. You can't do that.
Man, look, I ain't gonna lie. Sometimes you be having PTSD of bad mics, and you be like, man, niggas no, for real.
For real, because I used to.
The sounds might not be
hitting. I used to do it, too. So I used to do it too.
And I'll be like, man, fuck it.
You got to mic check that shit. I mean, because for real, man.
And then,
if people really like your music, they really don't want to hear you karaoke your shit. You know, like.
Man, I'm going to be honest. Look, we seen Jay Electronica probably 2 years ago and he performed.
Wait, where?
The Promontory.
Oh. I seen him at Metro and it was horrible.
And nah, like, that was incredible.
Oh, no, the Promontory was, that was the.
Bro, that man was out shaking hands, drinking with us and shit, bro. He was
took
legit,
my light
like,
at the end of the night.
It was crazy. Damn. It was crazy. Yeah, like, he was like capping. Like, but the thing with him was he kept pissing me off because he. Hey, like he knew the crowd was fucking with him so heavy that almost every fucking song was
that nigga
acapella. Was stopping every beat. Hold on, turn this off. And I'm going with him, but I'm like, come on, bro, I'm trying to hit that shit. Come on, bro.
Well, I mean, the beat makes the shit sometimes when you're like, man, these vocals over this beat sounds beautiful, you know? Like, so when they cut the beat in this rap, you're like, you're killing, but the beat complements it so much. You know, I mean, the beat's a lot of the song.
To be honest,
I mean,
the DJ was good enough. He'll just keep up with him doing that shit. But yeah,
I mean, I've been spoiled. I was working at the Promontory, so I seen a lot of artists. I seen Roy Ayers. I seen Slum Village.
Me too.
Wait, who Slum Village though? Which era? Like who was there?
Most recent era now. It was only two people.
Like it was Elzine, probably.
Nah, Elzai. I wish Elzai.
No, we wish Elzai.
Well, he jumped on the last Slum record though. Like,
he wasn't there.
He wasn't there.
Ninth was there, that was...
Man, not that same night, yeah. That was a different
night. No, that was not night, but ninth was there, that was crazy.
Who's the most captivating performer you ever seen?
Kanye West, for me.
Yeah. Where'd you see him at? What setting? Watch the
throne. Lucky, Ooh, I didn't go. I didn't get a chance. I was so mad. I didn't go to that either.
I ain't go to that either.
Him and my brother went to that show. I was so mad. I didn't go. I mean, what happened? I don't even know. It was.
Was it United Center?
Yeah. Yeah. Him and Jay, yeah, yeah, like just saying all for them, like.
Bro, I remember actually, I was at South Bath, and they was doing, this was like a year, probably two years.
Yeah,
it was like probably like 2 years after Watch the Throne came out, and then niggas was like, "Hey, Hov and Kanye is playing the Samsung Galaxy. They doing Watch the Throne all the way through, but you can only get in if you have a Samsung Galaxy."
You gotta think about it. This is right around Amanda Carter time.
Oh, yeah. He did the phone thing.
Yeah, I'm like, fuck.
You trying to cop a Samsung
Galaxy? I'm like, it's dead. It's lit though.
I mean, that was like,
no cap. I think I had a Galaxy right
now. I want to be They said you gotta show a Galaxy in order to get into the party, man. I was like, fuck, bro.
How they coming?
I went to Yeezus. That shit was hard. Man, that's my favorite shit for
That's real. The one I'd be like, I'm still mad to this day. I'd be on maybe Grilled or some hype beat shit. And I'm like, I gotta see. I gotta see what the merch. Like, I fuck with that merch so heavy and it's so simple. But no, some of the unreleased merch. Yeah, Kanye got a lot of unreleased merch.
What about you? What's your most captivating performer? Wait, no, you.
So you see, I was like, I ain't gonna lie, gotta be Beyonce.
True.
Oh, yeah, I say Facts. Beyonce too.
Facts. I didn't see it.
I need to go.
I was sorry I didn't go to on the road.
Coldplay was sick too.
Coldplay was sick. Shoot, Guns N' Roses was dope too.
Yeah, Guns N' Roses.
I'm keeping it a buck.
I feel you.
The spectrum's growing.
It's crazy when you see an old nigga pop out and be doing the shit like he really doing the shit.
They started good. That's all I'm gonna say. Guns N' Roses, for real. Eventually it grew to us like, hey, honey, you want to go home?
He got a little boy.
Shit like that.
Axel was like, I'm tired as shit. Yeah, I can't give you Welcome to the Jungle like I used to get.
No, that was the song that had it lit. That's why I was like, that was probably the second, third song. And I was like, oh, shit. It was jumping. But after that, it kind of died down.
Yeah, no doubt. For sure. Mm-hmm. With what are you guys feeling like being in Chicago? How do you feel about the current state of Chicago rap music?
We here is pretty good. Yeah, we listen to music with around,
I listen
good.
To that dude Nigel a lot. He's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty dope.
No bullshit. It's a couple Chicago artists for sure.
The mainstream artists like Dirk.
Oh yeah, of course Dirk is killing it now.
I just be at the job every day. Every day I be at my job and I just be like, "Pooh Shiesty, that's my dog. Who you know I'm really shiesty." Yeah. All I just repeat it all day at work.
You like that. Yeah, Chicago drill rappers would definitely get you.
Herb's doing his thing.
Herbo is crazy. His growth is fucking nuts, man.
I'm not even going to stay up.
Herbo's last projects, I'm so fucking, I can't be more impressed. His growth is just nuts, dude.
I can't be more impressed.
I was surprised.
It's his best project. I was like, Herb.
It's nuts. Bro, and then he dropped the deluxe and it was fire. Oh, whole shit.
That's how I feel about Dirk.
And then the EP before then.
Sessions or whatever.
Sessions. Woo. That's what I
never heard that whole project.
I've come to the conclusion
Herb's deluxe albums are better than his regular albums. Because the first, like,
well, it's a whole new album.
It is. Now, I hope that shit die out eventually.
I'm so tired of this deluxe ass shit.
I need sales. I gotta get them.
I just really hope Herbo don't get locked up because, man, he's on a roll. He's killing shit.
For them Jets? Come on. I'm gonna be honest with you. Nah, I ain't even gonna say that.
I was just about to say, I'm not even gonna say what I was gonna say.
Herb got that. But either way, you know, Herb is Herb. That's all I would say.
So yeah, man. Like I said before, I know y'all niggas working out here, man. What y'all got coming up?
Oh man. Yeah, I just dropped a song today called 21 Freestyle, produced by East Tumor. It was an old East Tumor
joint. Oh yeah, that's my boy for real.
He just had clearly one of the albums of the year last year, and you know, he's killing it right now.
Yeah.
So I tapped into one of his old beats and I just freestyled over it and called 21 Freestyle. Then I got another track dropping on Valentine's Day. After that, I'm finna just start promoting my first debut project. Like I was telling you earlier, it's called Hell If I Know. And first single for that gonna be called Hourglass. And that's probably gonna drop like the last week of February or the first week of March, one of the two. But, you know, we just gonna keep them coming. That's all I can tell you. How we come. $URT. That's what we going by. So,
what about you, Nigel?
Could be feeling like West Side over here. You guys got two more projects from me, and that's it. But nah, I got Eternity at Genesis. That's coming. I'm not gonna say soon, but that's the next project you guys are getting from me. Quarantine Volume 2 is still out. Yes. Available everywhere. Go stream that.
Hard.
Beetlejuice video coming, Jupiter Heights. That's it.
How's creating during the quarantine been? Has it been beneficial?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you was asking him that earlier, and I was like, nah, like it's perfect. Cause we was talking to Chuck originally, trying to find a studio when like quarantine shit was kind of starting off like last March. And shit. Couldn't find a studio. So like, you know, it came to the point where we decided to DIY it. So started recording at the crib. That's when it was just like, oh, you know, shit was more consistent. That's when he started the quarantine projects, because both of the projects is recording the crib type shit. So it's just like,
well, I've been recording so much at home, I don't even want to go back to the studio. I'm honest.
Okay, that's how I'll be feeling.
I don't
even
want to go. I don't want nobody to be telling, nah, I don't know, hours, blocks, none of that, bro. Unless I own it, I'm good.
Thanks.
No, yeah, I feel you, bro. That's how I be honest, bro. And because I like to do my shit how I like to do my shit.
Yeah, you get as many takes as you want to. Exactly. You get more comfortable. It's quarantine been very nice on the recording side. That's the best thing. The creating and the process, the art, just being, I can't think of the word solemn, and just by yourself a lot or with other creatives, it's really been good.
Now, quarantine's been amazing for creatives. I mean, it puts you really, you get so much time to yourself and to tap in, really. We've all done it too. Like me and Perry and everybody's been just tapping in on like trying to create merch and bring the podcast to the next level, and Perry with his music shit.
Yeah, yeah.
It just given, if you have a creative direction, it's giving you a lot of more time because you're not merch, consumed
thank
with
you
like,
for the mask.
Oh yeah. The it's mask. Oh yeah, man. Thank you for supporting the shit, man.
Like, FV, man. That's how we come off and get that shit tatted, man.
And it's really dope too. Like, and I kind of want to touch on that from what you were saying about the studio thing. I think the reason this conversation was so good is because y'all got to kick it for like an hour before we started. Mm-hmm. And I think that brings a different energy to the conversation, you know, when you get to know each other, kick it, feel the vibe. And that's how studio sessions could be. But I think they're a little rushed because you're paying bread for the fucking thing.
It's
you
like,
know?
Yeah, the engineer is just there to do his job. And that's to get you the fuck out of there in a sense, because he got other
but
people.
But sometimes vibing, as long as he vibing with you, man. That's why I'm not finna go to no nigga that I'm just like, every nigga I ever work with, engineer and shit like that, he like, yo, a lot of this get cold, bro. Like, yeah, I know, nigga. That's why
studio,
I'm with
shout
right
out
now,
to Fort Knox. You know, this Go House.
Fort Knox, shit, yeah. It's a lot of people. Yeah, but I'm not finna get no studios, no money. I'm trying to get money. So, hey, shout out Bandcamp for Bandcamp Fridays. Lord knows. Like, I don't know why haven't they been doing that? Like, that's, even though I just started putting my music on there, but I've been on that shit for years. Like, Mind Design and all that shit. Knowledge back in the day.
Hell yeah.
That shit.
I just sent Perry this article that I guess DistroKid is about to start reporting numbers to like the labels.
Yeah, I heard. It's just like,
they gotta do something, man. DistroKid don't be doing shit. Yo, you can't even talk to them. You can hit them niggas up. You can't even talk to them niggas. You gotta email them niggas.
That's what I said. Yeah, I was on.
I'm about to go to United Masters for real.
Fuck that. I don't know if you seen the Clubhouse episode.
What?
United Masters too. Yeah, fuck that too. United Masters, I was like, yeah, it's all about you getting it yourself.
Yeah, you done that. Just gotta figure yourself. There's ways to like get in touch with like Apple and other ways just to release it, but it's pretty hard to do it. But
you get your shit straight up.
So, what do you feel like the best viable way to release music is right now?
Oh, I know my next way I'm releasing music at 30 Genesis is gonna be hard copies. It's not gonna.
You're
be
doing physicals?
I'm doing physicals.
Hell yeah,
doing physicals.
I feel that. I feel you. My sometimes it's just like nice.
Physical.
Sometimes it's like nice to like see a product that you made. You know what I'm saying? To see a product that you made.
Then after that we doing cassettes at my first place. We just you know, you gotta switch it up. Yeah, gotta switch it up.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like a niche thing. So you feel like you gotta do other things besides streaming? Just to kind of get it.
I
keep it pushing.
Me personally, I feel like I drop early morning tunes, Running Through Feelings, Quarantine Volume 1, Quarantine Volume 2. In a sense, if you haven't heard it, shoot, I mean, I could step back and be like, I don't need to release no more music on I don't need to. I could just get my money through selling it physically, and that's what I want to do now.
Yeah, for sure.
I feel you. I feel like that's it. I'm like, I just don't want to, you know, like reporting numbers and all that. I'm like, it's really all about who listens to it and when they listen to it. So I mean, just that's it.
Yeah, I feel like Perry just kind of said it best. When you have a tangible product that you put your energy into, it's tight. Like if you can hold a vinyl, you can hold a CD. I mean, I guess to me, vinyl's dope because you get to see the album art displayed on a bigger scale.
I was actually going to do posters for my next, my debut project. And I was kind of like, that's, to me, that's no, it's like, I'm, in my eyes, I'm a bedroom rapper. But like, you know, to the people who buy that shit, I'm just going to be like, yo, that nigga doing something. So it's like,
I appreciate it.
Yeah, for sure. We're about to do a bunch of like wheat paste shit around the city. We're like getting our like art kind of shit.
I'm trying to get me a billboard. I already got one, bro. I'm like, nah, I'm driving the shit.
Yeah, like, sturdy is a crazy adjective to use right there. I like that. Sturdy. Well, shit, like, I know you got a little thing. You want to touch on anything else before y'all get out of here?
Touch on a lot. What? Shout out all of our producers.
Let's talk about it.
Who got the gal with the orange glasses? That man is killing it all the way straight out of United Kingdom. DJ Universe coming out.
That's a hard name. That sounds like, dang.
Yeah, the guy with the orange glasses. He spells it with letters only, so it's TGWOG. And that man is sick. And DJ Universe, Fero Rue,
Too Thick,
Ginger Apollo. It's got my song. Shit, East Over. I just did that shit, you know. So we going, what else? All my nigga Elijah, I don't know how to fuck to pronounce his last name, but he coming out of Detroit with it. And he did Pish Posh on More to Come, and that's a sick track. So.
Yeah, shout out Michigan. Michigan is so like quintessential in like rap shit, like from the Dilla shit to like Sesame Village, Guilty Simpson, like all those dudes.
But Dilla, all that shit, like follow, that Danny follow the Brown. Soup page.
Oh, you listening to new Madlib?
Oh, yeah, the new Madlib.
Dude, that new normal beat is crazy. Like, he,
I ain't listened to it yet.
Madlib put out a new project.
Yeah, thank y'all. Let's talk about the new music real quick. And
Yeah, for sure.
I was going to say, yeah, that one, and people sleeping on the new Al. You know, he did that little collab shit with Born and Raised. I got to listen to anything Al put out.
That whole lab was super weak, though. Like, the merch was weak.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I ain't bad.
Born and Raised. The thing about Born and Raised is like they have been such a great brand for like, dude, like Born 8-9 years like, now. But they've been putting out like weak ass shit. Like these collabs have been weak as fuck. You know, it's the Al shit is like, all right, this is mad, like super mid. But the music, I'm sure the music is great.
It was alright. I ain't gonna lie, but I mean, it was Alchemist, so I had to listen to it. Like the album he dropped on his birthday last year. I forgot what it's called. Fool Villain. That shit was sick. Mm-hmm. That shit was sick.
Yeah, that was hard.
The Madlib album is dope though too. That new Dirt. I was like, that deluxe.
I ain't heard the deluxe.
I didn't hear that. The new Kanye Dolph crazy. Is fucking crazy.
I was gonna say the Kanye crazy video.
You said something about Satch, just like the way music is dropping. It's hard not to get lost in it because just you said something. I'm like, I didn't even know the album dropped. So, but it's you know, I mean, I find myself listening to the same group of artists.
I think the new release section of the music apps, it's like paid to paid placement. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, dude, you should put everything that just came out in the new release.
I was surprised I seen the Bones album up there like that.
Yeah, I seen Bones up there.
Yeah, he just signed a big inspiration.
I ain't listened to it yet though, but I'm definitely putting
it
out.
I know, it was dope. I ain't gonna lie. I like the
anything Elmo drop, I'm down there go pop it. You know what I'm saying? Anything drop, I'm peeping.
He like pioneered that whole wave and like niggas that's out right now.
Peach X, they wouldn't be alive if I say live, but Bones, like, they wouldn't be around.
Bones inspired a lot of music I be doing now. I don't care.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's dope when people give love to their inspirations, man. Because, like, nobody really, I mean, organic ideas are hard to come by. You know, we're all inspired by a lot of things, whether it's art, fashion, fucking music.
Be like,
music.
Nigga, stop lying. Niggas be out here.
And a lot of people want to lie about it.
Nigga, you lying, bro.
Like, I'm inspired by myself. It's like, no, you're not. You know what I mean? Like, you hear shit and you take it in and you internalize it and you put something else out, you know?
Yeah, niggas be like, don't want to be like, oh, I'll be like, it's some shit. Like, I'll be like, when I first started listening to Wiz a long time ago, like, I was like, bro, I'm going to smoke weed every day.
And I did that because of Wiz.
I ain't going to lie.
I was spitting shit like that before I was smoking too. And it was just like, I just like listening to it. So that's how I know I'm going in a good direction for kids that don't smoke. I'm a bad influence. Listen to my music.
But I think Wayne, I heard Wayne say that shit before too.
Yeah, drop that cup. I never forget.
Do you see yourself like stop mentioning drugs on in your music song?
Eventually, I'll have kids.
Okay, I don't know if that happens.
Who knows what'll happen.
How do y'all feel about that? With like influentially, do you think it really like drives people to want to fuck with it when you talk about drugs a lot and shit?
I don't know. It's funny.
It's about it. Me personally, it's really how you do it. To be honest,
it is how you do it.
It's really how you do it. It's.
Do you mean like in a genuine way? If you're really speaking on it genuinely,
I mean, if the underlining issue is I need help, yeah, it is cool. I feel like that's me. That's what I feel like. If that's the underlining issue, then yeah.
All I gotta say is Badu said it the best. When it comes to it, like
it's not really up to the artist to tell you what to do. It's just up for the artist to be honest. So but that's all you can be.
How do you feel about like Future shit? I feel like Future didn't do half the shit he's be talking about. Like
he doesn't. I'll be telling him too, man. Be drinking like drug wise and shit. Yeah. You know,
I mean, I'm not gonna say Future doesn't do it, but he's
that man almost 40.
He would die.
He got to be a dad. He got to go get him some Air Max. What's it called? Whatever. Join some Dick's Sporting Goods and shit like that.
Some Air Maxes? Yeah, you ain't fucking with Air Maxes?
Damn, this nigga Jorge just came in clean as hell. Hold up. Hold up. Jorge just came in here clean as hell. Give him the thing.
You can't come here clean. Like the cleanest piece of man of all.
Now that we're talking about it real quick before we get out of here, what's y'all favorite sneaker? Whether this year, just in general. Because you know we were talking about clothes hella.
I mean, look. If you guys haven't noticed, when you guys were all talking about clothes, I did not say a thing.
But you be getting shit off. I know. You got the chaps.
I just know what to do. I know what to do. I know how to fit in with you guys.
So you don't dork out.
I'm a chameleon. I swerve in and I'm like, all right, if I don't do this,
you
I'm
mean last get, year this year.
We gotta talk to the hype beast. What's up with the sneaker 2020?
I can tell you.
What's up?
I can't tell you.
What's
of course couple. The Nike shit is sick.
How you feel about the Nike Sakai shit? I love that shit. The Sakai, like the vapor waffles and stuff.
Which color? That's the one which with the like two.
I know what you're talking about. Which colorway? The yellow ones?
All of them. Sick. The maroon and white shit was crazy.
No, the green, all that turquoise. Yeah. I was dope. Would never wear it. But yeah, it's sick. That's all I'm saying.
So what would you wear that you maybe missed out on this year? Or how do you feel about I want to ask you something. How you feel about the hype on the Jordan 1s? Owens,
bro. Oh, God.
No, the hype on the Jordan 1s. How you feel? How Jordan 1s are just ridiculously hard to cop now?
I don't know because I don't try to cop them.
You don't wear Nike.
Try to cop them. I don't. I like you know my favorite shoes right now at the crib is the Vivian Westwood Asics. Those are my favorite shoes. I got Vivian Westwood Vans too. But
you just took it to a whole
different level. That's me. That's what I'm. That's like.
No,
that's
I appreciate I you. That's amazing.
That's
yeah.
what I do. The little ASAP NAS Converse too are sick. Those are really dope.
How you feel about the Joe Fresco's Converse? The ones
those are cool. If you would have said New Balance, I would like, oh yeah,
those New Balance were crazy.
But like, it's ones that's coming out with the same number. I forgot what
the 992s. Those are the 992s.
Another one, and they doing red and blue and white instead of like the pink, the Valentine colors like he did. And it's sick. I can't tell you the brand. If I find out, I'll send it to you. But
yeah, like hit us for
sick,
sure.
Though. I forgot. It's sick.
Like we definitely need to all keep in touch. It's been like a great conversation.
New Balance, sure. Hell yeah. Now, the 327. Shout out Westside.
Shout out New Balance. Hey, if anybody needs a sponsor, it needs to be New Balance for real.
Yo, shout out Kawhi Leonard, Clippers. You know,
we're working on the other thing, bro. Can't be talking about New Balance.
Hey, look, New Balance is New Balance. They doing their thing.
We be pumping them hella, man. I'm gonna hit Lewis and Austin, man.
This Neff talking, man. They the most comfortable shoes out. No cap.